All right, race fans, here we go. The third and final 20-lap Jimmy Mowry Memorial Race. Todd Morrow on the inside, EJ5, Eric Jacobson on the outside. Cars slowing down the backside. Looks like Ricky Weeks in the R12 car. Clayton Turner. Back to green. Here we come. Lap three on the Car Smart Auto Sales scoreboard. Morrow, your leader. Jacobson, second. Grizzle, Ellis, and Weeks. Here they come. Back underway here to Cleveland Speedway. Still leading Eric Jacobson, about a 3-4 car length advantage, and a back marker car coming up. That is going to be Bo Eaton once again. DJ Hayes bringing out a caution as he dropped down to the bottom of the racetrack right in front of Todd Morrow and Eric Jacobson. Bill in second. Jacob Grizzle in third. Derek Ellis fourth. Mike Weeks in fifth. On the outside looking in, Jake Knowles in the A19. Here we go. Knowles working on the fifth place of Mike Weeks. smooth sailing for Todd Morrow as we are seven laps away from the checkers. Battle for fifth as Morrow runs away and hides from the field. Eric Jacobson about an eight car lengths back in second. The battle for third, for fourth, fifth, and sixth. Jake Knowles wants it. He's on the inside. Slide job on the milkman. This time by. Jake Knowles has fifth. Now he's going to work on Derek Ellis. White flag coming out to Todd Morrow, the 48 car. The A&K Transportation, KC Graphics. Manuel Mowry, number 48 race car, has swept the Jimmy Mowry Memorial here at the Cleveland Speedway. Wilson Auto Sales, A&K Transportation, Cleveland Speedway, Stealth Racing Carburetors, Race Tech Powered, KC Graphics, in victory lane here, about to climb out of the car, taking all three wins. Getting congratulated by your second place finisher tonight. Climbing out of the car, the blonde bomber, Todd Morrow. Man, I tell you what. You just took $3,000 from your old man. How's that feel?
Well, it feels pretty good. I guess he'll be mad at me in the morning. I have to buy a supper. But I appreciate everybody being here. Thanks for the fans coming out. And the racetrack was awesome. Congratulations to Eric and Ross White on their championship. And I'm just happy to be here.
Man, I tell you what, it looked like you had smooth sailing there for a while, but the lap cars were giving you fits, especially on that last one. Almost had a crash with one of the slower cars.
Yeah, it was a pretty bad deal, but they got out of the way for the most part. You know, they're racing, you know, this economic times is tough, and, you know, they deserve to race just like I do.
Neil, your dad comes up, gives you a hug. I knew Jolie Johnson, and I knew Jolie Johnson loved going and watching RJ race all the time, and I know deep down that man loves watching you race too.
Yeah, we've had our tough times in the past, but we get along pretty good now, and I'm just happy he's proud of me and just glad we get along good.
All right, there it is, your winner here tonight, the Jimmy Mowry Memorial Event, Triple Crown, winning all three feature races and taking the $500 bonus from Elliott's Used Cars. $3,500 payday here tonight at the Cleveland Speedway.
Never seen a tie like that, only other one other time for a series, Battle of the Bluegrass. You ended up with one feature win at Wartburg, which I know you were so happy about, with $5,000 victory. He did win last night, put him two series victories. You are second in points. Congratulations on your tight points battle and runner-up this year, Ross.
Thank you very much. We had a really good car early in the night, and I don't know if I jumped the berm or what and got down in one and two and got in the wall, and from there on, we were just chasing our tail, trying to keep up with the car and the racetrack, and We just weren't able to get it all together tonight. But I just definitely want to congratulate Eric for, I mean, he looked great out there tonight, and he was awesome last night at Boyd's. And it's been a pleasure racing with these guys and working with Eric and Matt and Greg. And we've had a good year, though.
We decided mid-season that we would do just drop one race since that the series ended up having less races due to rainouts and such. Going into the final feature, you had to gain from 14th, you had to come to 10th place. You was able to make it to that 11th spot, I believe. That tied you for the points. 10th would have put you five over. I don't have my arithmetic with me. But you tie, we go back to the tiebreaker, the championship. That win meant a lot at Wartburg in front of that hometown crowd. I know that had to been just a thrilling victory down there in July as well.
Oh, it definitely did. This whole year has just been awesome. I mean, we really picked up our game from last year. Last year we always struggled when we came out to these shows, and this year once we figured our program out, we've really been in the top five basically everywhere we went. And so I'm definitely pleased with our performance.
Due to being the only driver to attend all 23 events in series history, you've been awarded the Cruise of the Champions Cruise for 2011. Congratulations. I know you're looking forward to getting back on the big boat with everybody.
Oh, yeah. We had a blast on that deal last year, and really looking forward to it again.
You guys worked so hard this season, and you put a lot of time and effort into it, as well as your parents and all the great people that help you and your sponsors. I'll let you thank them at this time.
Oh, man, I really don't want to even know where to start. Definitely got to thank Mom and Dad and my Uncle Rob and Mom's Business and Alternative Care, Steve and Marissa. They've been with us ever since I started racing, and they've really stood by us and really been our biggest sponsor. And then Matt and Greg and those guys, they don't give me money or anything, but working for those guys, and just it's basically like having a sponsor, so I got to definitely thank those guys.
I know it's just been a long, long season. You end with this. I know you could take this on to what you're going to build on with 2012 and go from there.
Oh, yeah, we can definitely see what we can gather up for next year. And I don't know if we're going to follow a series next year or just kind of try and hit the bigger shows around the house where we can try and make some money. But definitely glad to throw the checkered flag on this season.
It's been a long season. Congratulations.
Thank you, Chris.
Ross White driving the car number 0 tonight, race fans. Big Steve, it's all back to you. 2011 series champion from Santa Cruz, California. Won in a tiebreaker based on most wins this season. He had one more win than Ross White. 1,425 points. I just, what a victory. I mean, this is a huge victory. You finished incredible run with all three features, runner-up, and you are the 2011 series champion, the California Kid. Congratulations, Eric.
Well, thank you guys very much. Being on this side of the country and to come out of here with a championship means a lot to us. Ross was a little more consistent, I think, showing up and making all the races. We just happened to run good about every time we came here, and that's the way the points fall. My hat's off to him, the series, for having us, and really my guys for putting me in a good race car about every time we showed up and ran with you guys.
We really appreciate your support, and it's a heartbreak. Ross had some problems earlier, got caught up in the wall. The team scrambled, a rough finish last night. You was able to salvage three finishes, which put you, we took the best finish of the three races. That put you at about 210 points, so able to come out with that. You dropped a 0, which was one race missed. That was able to enable you to get to the points championship, and it's just weird how those numbers work. If we could just get NASCAR to do that.
You get rewarded for running good, and man, we had a couple wins with you, and it paid off and compensated for the race that we did miss. Ross is such a good kid. He works for me down at the shop. We did everything we could to get him this championship. We just, like I said, happened to run better than he did at the time. So I just got to feel good about my season out here and obviously the runs we had in the series, and look forward to seeing you again next year.
Congratulations, and $3,000 last night, $3,000 at Tazewell. Two tough racetracks to win at, and you was able to get your first win at Tazewell in May in a rain-shortened event, and last night at Boyd Speedway. There was some tough competition both times.
Well, any of these tracks nowadays are, the competition's tough, and I think Boyd's is probably one of the tougher tracks to race with the spoilers and the way that track transitions and the hard tires and so on. We've come down there about four or five times this year and just kept working on it, and last night it paid off.
Congratulations, and enjoy the ride back to California.
Yeah, it's going to be a nice plane ride home tomorrow.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much.